Morning, everybody. It's Brian. This is going to be the most important video you watch today. I guarantee it. It's called Bobby Sands led a hunger strike in 1981 at May's prison, also known as Long Kesh. And after 66 days, he passed away at the age of 27, and his death sparked widespread protests, renewed violence in Northern Ireland, and his hunger strike and subsequent death became a symbol of Irish Republican struggle and inspired others to continue the fight for political status. So this is a political song. Today we've got Black 47, Bobby Sands. Let's go.
My name is Bobby Sands, MP, born in the city of Belfast, divided by religion. I grew up fast. I was stabbed and I was spat upon. Family ran out of its home. There's only one solution: turn the whole system upside down. But the system had other ideas. I got lifted for carrying a gun in a trial without a jury. I got 14 years for the judge. Screws beat me up regularly, but they couldn't break me because I had the love of my comrades and a burning faith in my cause. Still, I left a girl outside pregnant, married to one other man. Now I got a son, a pain in my heart, but he doesn't recognize his own man. His soul's on ice. But they can't stop the desire.
This is one of the most controversial events in Northern Irish history, and it still moves people to this day, even though he died in 1981. Wow. So I'm speechless, really. He grew up in a Catholic family. Of course, the Protestants from the South. But he was politically active as a teenager. And like I said, this still resonates with people today. The Irish people are so proud. So proud of Bobby Sands.
To break on out. When your heart is on fire, we wouldn't wear the convict clothes, so they stripped us to the bone, threw in some threadbare blankets. But they cheered us about our nakedness as we slumped out down the halls. We wouldn't come out of the prison cells. We smeared shit on the prison walls. Stuck in an 8-foot concrete box with a Bible, a mattress, and the threat of violence every day. Can I make it through these 14 years? Will my son remember my face? I don't blame her for the separation, but for Christ's sake, let him keep his name. Your soul's on ice. Whoa. simple things we ask of them. Five simple things denied. But Thatcher will not compromise. I ask my mother's permission to finally break her heart. We've come to a decision. Hunger strike. Three comrades starve behind me. I pray to God that my death will lead to compromise. I can no longer see your face. My bones break through my skin. I go back to Belfast City. You can't cage my spirit in. Your soul's on ice.
If someone knows who those other men are, I'd appreciate you listing those for me down below. What an amazing story. I mean, the power of just asking for those five simple demands, the British government saying, no, you can't even have those simple things. That was only in 81, so not that long ago, right? Now we're in 2023, so... Was that 42 years ago? Wow, it's amazing the callousness of the British government to deny these things, that these men would have to go through this. And Bobby Sands, as the representative for them, dying in 1981 after 66 days. And he talks about his bones just coming through his skin as he's not getting any nourishment at all. Now, as some of you know, I have great-grandparents from Ireland, from the south, actually, from County Cork, but this is revealing to me, and really, wow, it's stunning to read. Now, Bobby Sands had writings and diaries that were smuggled out of the prison, and they were put in a book later on called One Day in My Life. Bobby Sands. So I'm going to look for that, and I'm going to read it. I would encourage you to do the same. Also, if you have read the book, please let me know. It sounds fascinating. There is a book. My favorite book is A Day in the Life of Ivan Denisovich, and it's Solzhenitsyn. If you get a chance to read that amazing book. It is about the a prisoner in Russia as well. But he lasted 66 days. Wow. I've heard people comment about Bobby Sands before and some of the other Irish songs that I've done. And I'd appreciate knowing more, please. I didn't do enough research on this. I found the Bobby Sands information and But I want to know more. I want to know if those doves maybe are representative of Bobby and the others finally being free. If they were set off outside Long Kesh prison, I don't know if that's the case or not. But someone can let me know. I'd appreciate that. Please subscribe and give me a thumbs up. Thanks a lot. Take care now.